husband's name is Sam Berman. He had a stroke in 1989, and at the beginning he was better, and then he wasn't better, and then he got worse, and it was multi-infarct dementia as a result of the stroke. I took care of him for 6 years, and I didn't even realize that he had to come here, except when the doctor said he had to come, it was quite bad, and it was rather urgent. We only had a 4-month wait because it was that urgent.
My name is Albert Waknin. My mother is Cécile. We are a family of 5 kids. We came from Morocco. My mother is an unbelievable woman. About 5 years ago, she would be able to tell you about interest rate, about exchange rate, about the US dollar. She was very much in touch. And gradually things started to drop down, and she became ill, and she started to lose the control of certain things. She started to forget. My mother, when she came here 2 years ago, was not in good shape at all.
My name is Anne Goldenberg. I'm age 71, and I've been here 7 years. I have cerebral palsy, and I was born like I am now. And after my parents died, I lived alone for 8 years. But then later on, I started to fall. And they took me into St. Mary's. And one doctor told me I should find a place where I needed more care.
Residents who come here at Maimonides who suffer from dementia, often what they need the most from the staff is a feeling of security and of comfort because they're scared in their new surroundings. They're afraid because they do not understand. They do not know the people around them. It's a new surroundings. They have to get used to new routines, to new habits. Everything is in their world is turned around. So it's very scary. And if you're cognitively impaired, you do not understand what's going on. So they feel powerless and afraid. Through the years, there's been many changes at Maimonides that I've seen. As we understand more and more what cognitive deficiency is and how it works, we are able to develop programs that are better suited to their needs at whatever level of impairment they're at. Some of the programs that are more beneficial to the residents are we have like a baking group, because this makes them do things that seem simple to you and I, but when you don't know what a recipe is, what is the bowl for, it's all these simple steps that they're able to do with guidance and with the therapist there to help them, and this is very rewarding to them and they feel they've accomplished something today. Pet therapy is another activity where we see the residents really react and enjoy. Many of them had pets when they were younger, so they really enjoy having the dogs and the cats come to them, and they really perk up.
Il y a une chose qui est super, et d'ailleurs c'est dans l'étage où elle est ma mère, au troisième étage, il y a le salon de thé marocain, okay, qui est vraiment magnifique. Elle adore aller au salon de thé.
C'est bon.
Ça lui fait rappeler beaucoup de choses.
Oui, c'est bien.
Il y a des décorations marocaines et c'est très intéressant pour elle.
For me, bluntly put, it's the only game in town. He's cared for, he's clean, he's not frustrated. There's only a limited amount of things I can do for Sam right now. His needs are taken care of. I know he's safe. Okay. And that, you know, it doesn't sound like much, but from a caregiver or, you know, from my point of view, it's all there is.
There's been a tremendous improvement since she came to Maimonides. Her morale is very good. She sees a lot of people.
C'est très bon.
And Maimonides has the things that she likes.
This is my home. Well, I'm very comfortable here. I know exactly where to go, and that's my home.
Maimonides has made a lot of progress. We've done some amazing things. Since 1996, through the generosity of our donors, we have contributed more than $5 million towards major improvements in facilities and services, and will continue to do so. Maimonides is a place with strong commitments to its residents and Jewish tradition.
Most other institutions don't have the quality nor the number of donors and volunteers that we do. In addition, our staff are extraordinary, and it's with this group of people that we're able to work with the residents and make the quality of their lives much, much better.
The support of the community for Maimonides Hospital is of extreme importance. Without it, many of these benefits that make their life easier could not occur. Without your help, we could never do this here. I think that we have to realize that Maimonides is foremost in our community. They need our support. We must have it. And we are helping some older people that have done in their life the things that we have to do now, and that is support charities, hospitals, and especially this one.
We're very lucky to have Maimonides. We have to do what we can to keep it going.